New data from the American Cancer Society says that colorectal cancer is now the leading cancer killer for men under the age of 50, and it ranks second for women under 50, just behind breast cancer. To help bring awareness to this disease, Dr. Maen Abdelrahim joins us now. And what hospital do you hail from, doctor?
I work at the Houston Methodist Hospital, Neal Cancer Center.
Okay, well, very good. Well, we're glad to have you with us this morning. Selfishly, I am in that group, just under 50, a male. And what exactly is colorectal cancer? What should we be looking out for?
Well, colorectal cancer is a cancer that comes from or arises from the last part of our digestive tract, the colon and the rectum. If you look at the colon, it actually is a muscular tube. And the function is just to push the waste and byproduct out of our body. The lining layers, which is the innermost layers of the colon, actually can have mutation and changes that lead to overgrowth of these cells. These cells become like a polyp. Most polyps actually are benign, but some polyps can change to cancer, and that's where the colorectal cancer initiate or like arise from. This cancer can grow inside the tube, cause obstruction or problems, and can grow outside the tube, causing perforation and metastasis to the other side. So it's a serious disease if it's missed, but it can be cured if it's caught early on time.
What kind of symptoms should we be looking out for? You know, something happens, I'm worried that might be I have colorectal cancer, right?
Yeah, the symptom can be varied, actually, like anemia, fatigue, and mainly from the right side of the colon. If the cancer comes from that side, most of the initial symptom can be anemia and fatigue. A change of the bowel habit, constipation, or for sometimes diarrhea, and if it arises from the left side of the colon. Blood in the stool, and the blood can be two type. I mean, the red blood that can be seen usually if the cancer is of the lower part of the colon, or the blood can be appear as a black tarry stool, which is usually in the cases when the cancer arises from the right side of the colon. Weight loss, abdominal pain, these are also non-specific but common symptoms can raise a red flag that there's something wrong, or there's a chance, or there's a risk, what do you call it, cancer in the colon or in the rectum.
Well, if you notice those symptoms, obviously you need to talk to your doctor. What's going to happen then? How do you detect it, and then how do you treat it?
Yeah, once you have these symptoms, there's going to be some workup. And believe it or not, some of these actually, like cancer, can be diagnosed incidentally. Before the patient have symptoms, usually they go for a screening colonoscopy, and they find like, you know, a lesion or a mass, and that biopsy, and end up like to be colon or rectal cancer. But when they have symptoms, you know, they present to their caregiver, and there's going to be some diagnostic workup, like, you know, scans in the abdomen and pelvis, and colonoscopy, and usually like associated with a biopsy of that lesion. It can be from the colon if it is early stage, or it can be from a metastatic site, like, you know, a liver or the lung. And once that biopsy is done, it can be sent to pathology to confirmation of the disease, and that, you know, give you the diagnosis. And then after that, you're going to talk with your oncologist about what next and how we can treat it.
Okay, and even if I don't notice symptoms, do you have any recommendations for people certainly of a certain age? Should we be getting a yearly colonoscopy, or is it not that often?
Yeah, before it used to be the age for colonoscopy around 50, but lately we would start noticing there's increased incidence in the younger population, younger than 55. So the guideline has been changed since 2021, and there's a recommendation to start colonoscopy at age 45. And it shouldn't be only colonoscopy. Sometimes other tool for screening for colorectal cancer can be involved, like, you know, stool-based test, you know, like a DNA test or blood in the stool can be another way of detecting and screening for colorectal cancer.
Okay. Well, that's a lot of information. You broke it down really well for us. Thank you, doctor, for